Here is my third restoration of this iconic grandmother clock radio, designed by famous industrial designer Raymond Loewy in 1931 at the age of 38, and built by Westinghouse exclusively for the Canadian market. The Columaire 801 is the combination of an 8-tube super heterodyne receiver and a New Haven Westinghouse electric clock with automatic control. This clock is very unique, featuring a second hand that moves in 1 second steps and even makes acoustic ticks like a mechanical clock. The second unique feature is a mechanical timer, the rundown time of which can be preset from a few seconds to 3 minutes. The timer is started when power is lost and the clock stops, interrupted when power is restored to let the clock resume where it stopped, and timing out after the preset time, after which the clock would not start again when power is coming back. So, if you see your clock working, you know that it is accurate to within the interval you had preselected. The clock works perfectly after servicing, which is extremely rare. Watch and listen to the faint clock ticks in this clip. The radio is an 8-tube early super heterodyne receiver with powerful push-pull audio based on a pair of 45 triodes, like in several General Electric and RCA radios of this vintage. The 8-inch field coil speaker opens to the top and distributes sound equally into the room. The chassis is considerably smaller and lighter than that of its US counterpart model WR8. The cabinet therefore is smaller too, needing only 1 square foot of real estate and 54 inches of height. Another Canadian bonus is a beautiful burlwood inlay on the front right below the clock. The dial is virtual, being the projection by the pilot lamp of a scale film onto a mat screen. The radio works perfectly, but AM reception here in Chilliwack is lousy, so please listen to my cell phone connected first through an AM transmitter and later through a newly installed 3.5mm phone plug.
Awaiting us, that you should bat cleanup.
Okay, so you're going to go first. Yeah. All right, sounds good.
Okay, Mr. Abbott, your argument in 3, 2, and 1. He is Jake Pretenda. All of 23 years in this fine planet in our fair province. He is lovable, he is gullible, he is Shotgun Jake, he is ours. We shall not tear him down for having some harmless fun, right? It is Manny being Manny. We love Manny. It is Marshawn being Marshawn. We love Marshawn.
And now the phone plug.